so wrong. Hallelujah. That's all right. As the old Kedushim would say, that's all right. Certainly, you can dine on the delicacies of Almighty Yahweh in your Shua for that profound revelation by the utterance of the Ruach HaKodesh, the Spirit of Yah, speaks unto a nation, his Am, his people, the beloved of his bosom. Not all are his beloved. You know, my Zachin, as I think, as I ponder, I meditate upon things. I was talking with one the other day, and this delusion that everyone seems to possess, and it has been created by a delirious whore known as Christianity. She's a slut. She's a Jezebel. And so many want to take the tenets of what they have learned from Mama and Daddy, and they think that it is right. Well, Mama was wicked, and Daddy was wicked. She taught you lies. She brought you up in lies. And so you think the doctrine of her strength has been based upon imams? And so as I engage with people, I see the ignorance of a nation, his people. We are ignorant. He calls us satish. We're just like a prostitute, a whore. You think a prostitute trusts any of her johns? She doesn't trust a one. She sells herself. We have sold ourselves to our emotion, our inclinations. And through the delusion of our own corrupt conscience, and we think we are right. And so we despise the muzah, the correction, the instructions that bring us to the near, the light of Torah. You can talk about your damn Jesus all you want to. He doesn't mean a damn thing. Oh, he is cursing us. Stop that, silly man, silly woman. You let your children hear 50 cents, he bumped down on them. You'd be surprised what your daughters and sons are listening to, all right? So don't give me that bull. I'll use the words Geluth Shore. In other words, we would say, don't give me that bullshit. Oh, you silly people. We're so silly. I'm going to teach today and preach. I want to read a letter from a precious Baptist Ayon. She writes, I don't like to read things because we have this tendency to think that one promotes themselves. No, Yah promotes his messengers. They're not afraid of the faces of the people, whether they reject them, denounce them, or deny them. It doesn't mean a damn thing, Israel. And so this frivolous whore has taught us to sell ourselves to the highest bidder. This is the way I do things. No, we do it the way Yah commands. You know, how can it be you find these ill-reputed houses of whoredom and people ask questions according to their unlearned abilities? So you think this child can propose a question to me of any dynamics or depth, and they ask silly questions. People ask me some of the most silliest questions, and they think they're deep and spiritual. They're stupid and dumb. Even a jackass knows how to go to the master's trough and eat. And we, the remnant of Yisrael, we don't even know how to eat out of the hands of Yahshua HaMashiach. And I find their questions so silly, and they're so uninformed, and they think they know everything.
Don't trust no man.
That's what the whore, she never trusts a man. And that's what Christianity has taught you. That's what the whore has taught you. And yet you trust your own damn wicked heart. The hidden man of your heart. That you hide some of the most vilest of things that you call treasures. You trust that damn thing. Nobody gonna tell me nothing to do. I know no one is. There's one profound thing that before Yahshua ascended, he descended. He gave gifts unto Geba. He didn't give it unto these little effeminate boys that call themselves men. The Nahar. He gave it unto the Geba. He gave gifts unto men. He made some Shulishim. The ones of the power, the authority of Torah. The one that pronounced the revelation of Yahshua HaMashiach. He gave, or he nathan, he bestowed upon those that were the Navim, or the prophets, or the messengers of death, destruction, and reconstitution. And then he said, in the midst of that, I give you those that are the teachers of the Mizrach, those that teach the dynamics of the Torah, and they shall carry this truth unto Yisrael scattered abroad. And I give you the Murray, the teachers, to refine things in your bosom. He said, above all that, I give you a re'ach, that shall guide you to the pasture where to eat, what to feed on. Yeah. So we call God, we don't call our God a lie, the God of our deception, the God of our wicked belly, but we call Almighty Yah a lie. He gives us leaders after his heart. Yeah. And a leader will feed and guide us. Either that is a lie, what Jeremiah said, or it is the truth. And true men of Yah the Geba will feed us with knowledge and understanding. The ability to discern, not out of your wicked mind. Let me see what he's about. I'm going to discern him. You child of hell, you don't even know what discerning is. You don't even know what discerning is. You've learned it from a whore. That's why many folks don't like me. So when I find one that like me, I will reciprocate that. Hallelujah. I'm not here for any inspiration or aspiration by the verbiage of man. I'm here to show his people their sins, their wickedness. I said to the Bath the other day, you daughters of Tizayon, you're going to be in trouble with Yah. Same, the men are in trouble. You have not taught the young women how to be beautiful. You let a slutty whore, Buanse, teach your daughter what the beauty of a woman is. Because your Jezebel spirit, you want to act like Buanse. Oh, heifer, cover yourself. And act like a woman. I'm a man. You don't have to worry about that. I'm going to teach some. You know, I said to my Ishon, last night as we conversed, I said, woman, I've been married to you nearly 36 years. And I said, of all those 36 years, I have never lied to her. It was no reason to lie. There was no reason to fabricate. There was no reason to hide. I have never, in all of my years of this betrothed unto this woman, I've never lied to her. And so hell, if you don't trust me, go to hell. I've never lied to her. Has Yah lied to us? We're his woman. Never lied to her. Never tried to be facetious, beguiling, to trick. And so when I tell you something, you listen to what I say. I don't care about your emotions or your feelings if they are trampled on. I want to destroy them. There are not many that love me. That's all right. There were not many that love Yahshua. I have a profound teaching on the conclusion of the words Holocaust or Shuach, the burnt offering of the whole. I received this letter from the Sechutz. She says unto me, Reach David Israel, I cannot thank you enough. You issue the whole family there with you. I cannot thank you all enough for all the efforts, for all the zeal put into bringing real knowledge of the truth to us, Yah's people. And so this Achot realizes that this is not a one-man show. She says, I cannot thank you all enough. Your teachings of Torah energizes me deeply to do better, to understand the knowledge for the sure way of Yah's Torah can be understood. I am ready to turn off all of that other foolishness and just get to studying the Torah. She says to the Rabbi, my beloved messenger, simple one of Yah, for your genuine love and building of Yah's people. You see, we don't think because the way I talk. We're so used to this homogenized, superficial thing we call love. This damnable thing we've learned at the titty nipple of the whore. And so this convoluted image of love, the mother hasn't taught her daughter. Because the man is so effeminate, he doesn't embrace the great power that Yah has bestowed upon him, that his sons and daughters can see the power of his hand. Now hear this. One that is least among Yisrael writes me. And a man the other day said, you seem as though you're angry. No, I pronounce the judgment against sin. That if anyone loves you, does Yah loves us, he loves you, then he tells us the truth. I said to my Isha, it is amazing the people that think Yah is tough, and he is tough. He tells us about you. She calls this genuine love and building of Yah's people. She concludes here. You're a voice in the wilderness that I am so grateful for. There's only one voice, and that's the voice of Yahshua HaMashiach that speaks unto the nation of Yisrael. He's going to consume this wicked world and the death of hell. It is a wicked world. It is without Torah truth. We feel as though that we have to question everything, don't we? It's almost like an impotent, stupid mind. Can I show you a parallel, my Ima Basia? One goes to the doctor, sees the doctor, and the doctor says, you got phyllitis hepatitis chrome deficiency. And so you can't even enunciate the word. So you began to ask questions. And then when he began to speak in medical terms, you still don't understand. And so you walk away as dumb as you were before you ask him questions. And you can broadcast, well, I got for syphilis, cypotitis, and that's how stupid we are. Your mind is not trained. We need the labab. We need the mind of Yeshua. We need the conscience, the heart of Yeshua HaMashiach. And so this stupid generation asks questions by their own immaturity. I saw a man the other day. I said, it's amazing. He asked me all these questions. And of course, they cannot cause me to stumble. I said, no, I will answer from the book. What does it say? Get the Torah out of you. No. I said, no. Your opinion means nothing, man. You have nothing. I said, damn your Jesus. He didn't fight me either. Because he knew that I was genuine. I said, damn your God. He's not worth a damn. Your God is not worth a damn. And that's a fact. Every God is a dog. Every God is a dog. Every God. You have to listen to me to understand that. Some of you, your emotions are so fragile. He blasphemed the Holy Ghost. Damn the Holy Ghost. Damn it. Damn that deceitful lie you call the Holy Ghost. If Jim Baker had the Holy Ghost, T.D. Jakes got the Holy Ghost. Any longer fag dog got the Holy Ghost. Damn that filthy thing. I do have the Ruach HaKodesh of Yahweh. How can you say that? Because I'm a student. I study intently, but I work hard. I study as hard as I work. And so I know what the word holy and ghost mean. I'm unapologetic. And I will not apologize. We greet you, all our friends, and especially you, our enemies. We greet you, Yeshua HaMashiach, mighty name. For the Torah commands us, if our oyeb, those that are your enemy, those that see you as distasteful, those that conspire against you, if your enemy is hungry, feed him. And so I feed you the life of Torah, the substance of the tikvah, the hope that is beyond the natural element, that extend beyond the heavens of Almighty Yahweh. How about that? That's somewhat of a bold and brazen statement, is it not? So I greet you all in Yeshua's mighty name, the Shabbat. What a beauty. The Shabbaton. That we can have the Shabbat. We can rest. Don't have to worry about a damn Walmart or Walmart. Dollar General. We worry about the command of the general. We can rest. We shall rest. You're not going to bring your sin in this bayat on the Shabbat. Hallelujah. This precious sister called me yesterday and she says, Reach David. Someone, a congregation leader, told me of you. And informed me of whom you were and said, listen and go to this site and listen. And so the Ohot, she had a question as far as the Hamites. You know, I said to the Ohot, I said, my friend, even if you could identify all the Hamites, what is that relevant to your knowledge of Torah? Yah scattered his people. He scattered them abroad to the four corners. Not the olam, but the erech, the earth, the circumference. In every place, in every nation, They intermingle, they integrate it. You tell me 70 went down into Mizraim and 5 million came out? You tell me that the Isha of Yosef, we know who she was. This is the stupidity of a nation. You're not going to identify the power of the true remnant of Yisrael, but by one denotion. There's only one pronouncing. Yah says, I will hatab, I will write, I will inscribe the love of Torah in their mind, their heart, in their bosom. You will know Yisrael. And so this deceit of the lies of their doctrines, I listen to some of these men and these women that call. I don't listen to no woman. But they give them place to have authority, to rise up. Well, I want to ask you a question then, Mr. Preacher. You Jezebel, you better sit down talking to me like that. Now, if your man has no control of you, I will, because I'm the head of every woman. That doesn't mean I lay with them. You're not coming in usurping no authority over me. Hallelujah. You will need not take any charge over me. Be quiet. Sit back there. You sit and you listen, you will learn. Hallelujah. And so what they have done with the woman today, they say, get your education, baby. And they're lonely. They have no husbands. And the men of the diaspora, the dark hue skin, they're going and finding what they call love somewhere else. Well, he's just not equal to me. What do you have, heifer? You just have a job. You think you got something? He got a job. If he's a brick mason, that's all right. If he's a carpenter, what's wrong with that? If he digs a ditch, so what? This is the stupidity of a nation that has maligned the man. He made man in the excellent. I'm going to teach. Let me teach, all right. He gave him a beauty like no other creature. There's nothing more pronounced than a man. Nothing. His strength, that even the most ferocious beast of the jungle fears that. Even the lion, when he sees a man, he ponders at that thing. What is that? I don't care if he's a little skinny, small, one. That is a Messiah warrior. Whether he is 7 feet tall as a Watutsi, he fears that. Mm-mm. So he made us in an excellent fashion. And the same process that the enemy used at the beginning, he uses it today. And she gave unto him and he ate. And so the whore has taught the woman, with big daddy pimps like T.D. Jakes, honey, you're loose because you got a faggot, effeminate spirit. Yeah. You're loose, and they buy him. I tell you, woman, you're bound under him. He rapes you. He rapes your daughters. They sleep with your sons. They are pedophiles. They take your daughters. They lust for them at 13, 14, 15. They rob you of the beauty of your daughters. They rob your sons with effeminate ways. You buy that. You buy it. But I tell you the truth and you reject me. You denounce me. You don't like me. You don't care for me. But they love Eddie Long. They love that big hog of a hog, T.D. Jake. They love that little effeminate penny pimping Benny Hinn. And the dollar bill man, they love him to death. It's not funny. Because what we see in them, we see the genetics of that in you and your sons and your daughters. I don't see a damn thing for us to laugh. We used to these whorehouses where not here with me. I want to begin reading. It is one thing that is pronounced in man. I don't care how wonderful you think you are. I don't care who you think you are. What a man can take, as I have read, the Holocaust and some of these articles, When there's a nation like these wicked nations can build up an armament so prolific and so profound that they will burn the babies in the womb of the mother, that's a sadistic, evil mind. And they're found in what we call our superior nations, our superpowers, like America and Russia and Britain and England and France. They literally proliferate these weapons known as nuclear bombs. I want to read a little something that I'm going to teach. Yeah. What kind of a sick mind would create something that is so full of death? You love America more than you love Yah. You sell your sons and your daughter, I'm prosperous. You don't have any of the prosperity of Yah. You are a slave unto your lust and your vanity. And that is the only heritage you give your sons and daughters. They're bound by the shackles of darkness. The mother sell out herself for a damn job. She obeyed the man that is cruel and nasty to her. And yet when her husband man asks her, she goes off on him. And these little effeminate men, they see the harlots in their workplace, and they're kind and they go home, and they abuse and they ostracize their wife. He's a coward. He's a little boy. He's not a man. It is right. I want to show you the overkill of this nation. It says in this article, an explosive force of 100 megatons, awesome as it is, represents only a small proportion of the nuclear destructive power of the world. Since humanity, humankind as they will call themselves, can only destroy itself once, Yah's not going to allow that. He's going to bring his Shamash. He's going to destroy, he's going to eviscerate. He's going to bring a destructive force. He's not going to allow Hashatan to do that. Since humanity can only destroy itself once, nuclear overkills serve no purpose. Waste billions of dollars in maintenance costs and increases the possibility of use of nuclear weapons by terrorists. They must always point to the terrorists. So if anyone uses a nuclear bomb, it's a terrorist, right? So America has used the nuclear bomb. She has used her white phosphorus there in Iraq. She has dropped down bombs on Hiroshima and Nagasaki. So has Russia. So these are the terrorists. And they tell you that the Iraqis or the Iranians are terrorists. No, this whore is a terrorist. She terrorizes and steals and robs. And you love this whore? I love Yah. Even when I don't know how to love him, I love him. Well, how do you perform that? By Yah. Keep your mitzvah, your commandments ever present before my eyes. Do not let me be a conformist to this world system. I don't need nothing. I don't need no money. And I don't need no fine clothing. That's a fact. It says Russia has more nuclear weapon destructive force of 2,900 megatons, which is an ability. Listen, Russia has enough nuclear armament, just that one nation. It has the ability to destroy the earth over 29 times. Yet it speaks of the financial dilemmas that Russia is in. And they say, the article, it is a vast waste of the sum of money to maintain this strategic power they perceive they have to destroy. We must understand all power comes from Yah. Yah has raised up this methodical whore, maniacal whore called Russia. And this abusive Jezebel called America. That's why when a whore gets dressed up right, and if a man doesn't turn his eyes away from her, he wants her. He will buy her. And that's why everybody loves America. No man wants a virtuous woman, a woman of strength and character, where her mind is covered by the law of her Isha, where the power of her covering is a man. We don't teach that to our daughters. We bring our sons down to effeminate nature. And any mother raised a son to be a man child. And she can only do that by the authority of the law of the man. So the whole house is telling you, just let her do what she wants to do. Let her be free. She's not free. He is not free. They're in captivity. They're bound. While the total nuclear destructive power of the United Kingdom, France, and China represents only a small part of the world nuclear weapons destructive force, it is still enough power in those three little nations to destroy the earth seven times over. I'm going to stop there. You can go to the library and read on these things. What kind of sadistic mind enjoys the pleasure of death to that degree that they will burn your baby in your belly and kill you, destroy you, and then they will laugh at it. Got you. There's only one that goes about to and fro in the earth, seeking whom he may devour or destroy or shochath, to bring down to desolation. He is as a roaring, one that roars as a lion. He is one that seeks to kill, to steal, and to destroy. They're stealing the beauty of your daughters. They're stealing the nature of your wife, your husband. Mama, you act like a mama. You're not a damn teenager. Daddy, you act like a man. And stop acting like a boy. That your presence is pronounced. Mama, you act like a mama. Put something on your eyes. Cover yourself. I'm raw, okay? So there is one pronounced thing that Yah knows that is in the heart of man. I want to begin the embedded sheets in the book of Genesis. Greetings to you, my friends. And also those that are my oyeb, my enemies, Bereshit. Genesis chapter 6, one verse here, verse 5. It says, "And Almighty Yahweh, the Abba, the creator of all, he saw, Genesis chapter 6, verse 5. Yah was able to perceive, to understand, to yada, to know. He saw that the evilness, the rach, the vile nature, the corruption, the indisputed nature of man, the evilness of man." He uses the word great. It was not gadol, but it was rab. It was of great abundance, of great measurement, substance. He saw that the evilness, the ra, the evil, the evilness of man was great. And Yah says, and every call all, the whole, the substance of his nurturing. Every imagination, he saw his the things that he devised in his mind, the things that he pondered, the things that he considered. He saw that every imagination of the thought of man, of his conscience, of his love, was only evil continuously. His thoughts are tomid. They are continuously evil. They have been not nurtured by the Torah. When a man has 11,500 nuclear bombs and he wants more, that's an evil thought. When our hearts are so aggressive and so prone to be driven toward those things that are not even temporal, they're momentarily, and then it eludes you and it goes up as smoke. That the thoughts, the heart of man is only evil continuously. There is not a pure thought of our mind. That's what Shaul says unto the gathering of Phoenicia. He said, let the same mind that was in Yeshua HaMashiach, let that same Labba, the concept of the power of Yah, he said, let that mind be in you as well. And we got to corrupt their mind. It denounces the Abba. It rejects Torah. Well, this is the way I do it. You're doing it wrong. It's not right. And that brought man down to some effeminate form. He doesn't take the authority, but let them go to the job. And when Mr. Boss Man says, shut your mouth or fire. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir, Mr. Boss Man. Ooh, I got my house payment and my car payment and my child in school. Yeah, when the messenger of Yah, he doesn't question the boss man. She doesn't question that rude, callous-hearted woman that drives her like a dog. She doesn't talk smart. She doesn't say, well, I'll tell you something, baby. Nah. Mm-mm. She's afraid. It is right. The conscience, the Labba, the concept of a man's mind is only evil. It is ra. It is an insidious cesspool of darkness. What is the constitution of a cesspool of darkness? When there is no great love for Torah. When you don't have the power of the witness of Yeshua HaMashiach in your bosom. When your witness flows from this cesspool of darkness that is so corrupt. And Yah says, because of that, he said, damn it, kill them all. He said, damn it, I'm going to kill them all. I'm going to kill the babies that suck on the titties. You can let this wicked hood tell you, oh, they went into the kingdom. You are a damn liar. He said, kill the babies. Destroy them. He showed us an example of that when he said to Moshe, watch those of Korah, Abiram, and Dathan. And all of their appertaineth to them as they stood in the tents and in the doors of the tents. Yah said, I'm going to do a new thing. It was him, his servants, their wives, and their tithe. You want to know what a taff is? Son, bring that little Yarameya here. This is a taff. He needs the titty milk of his mama. Turn that baby around. No, no. Hold it up right there. This is a taff right here. That's a little baby. That's a taff. And the Torah said the earth opened up and they all went down into hell alive. We don't know, Yah. We got this convoluted concept of Yah Yisrael, and they all went down to hell alive. And fear was so pronounced among Yisrael that they ran and they cried and they hollered, spare me, Yah. That's a fact. You think those little dirty babies in Sodom and Gomorrah, you teach your babies this Sodom mind. It's the mind of Sodomites. That's why they press this damn agenda, faggots. And there's a blurring of what they call the gender. And they call everybody gods. Don't call me a damn guy. I'm not some fool. You know, they will call each other that. And they don't even know what the word guy means. It's just been passed on, the ignorance. They think they know what the Holy Ghost is, and they don't know. And that's a fact. Go ask your congregation leader or ask your pastor, okay? Hallelujah. He said, the thought of man's mind, his image of me is always evil. It is without the direction of Torah, and any thought that is created without the light of the knowledge of Torah in its proper perspective, it is a deception of darkness. It has came out of the bowels of hell, and it begins to remove you away from you. It doesn't cause you to embrace Yeshua HaMashiach. It causes you to remove far away from him. Your thoughts are not on him. Your mind is not on him. Your thoughts on television, your job, and hell all day at your laptop, your computer. You might as well talk to me. Hallelujah. Glad they didn't have that when I was coming up. I had to get outside and play. And because of that, my body is fervently strong now. I'm strong. I do anything I need to do. Hallelujah. And so the heart of man is only continuously evil. And Yah says, because of that, we know what transpired, don't we? There's a Nobi. He's a prophet. He is a scribe. He was a teacher. As Israel began to return from their shibuth, their captivity. See, our minds are captive today. Do not they use the phrase, quote, we know how to captivate an audience, unquote. So they captivate your mind. They captivate your will. That is simply bring it under captivity, under the shackles and chains of darkness, that you perform according to that spirit that has captivated you. We should be captivated by the testimony of Yeshua HaMashiach. We get a damn smile on our face in Yalmart, we march. And yet in the hearing of the Torah, we don't get captivated. When they go into those dingy, dirty whorehouses, those dirty places, those houses that are rebuilt tonight, and they're going to go and bump it up, baby. Come on, let's roll. Sure they are. Yet we enter into the presence of Yah. We think we know him without singing and dancing. You are a twisted, damn beast. You are a liar. You don't even know him. Well, I'm hurting in my knees. Hell, they have Granny a birthday party when she's 99. Get up, baby, with the cane. And she get a baby. I used to be able to do it. Come on. Ooh, ooh, ooh. You know I'm telling the truth. And the old foolish man say, girl, I still can do it. Come on. I got 2K. Ah, ba, 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 boom, 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 boom. And everybody thinks that's nice. Look at Granny. Ooh, Granny. And everybody get inspired to do what this filthy old granny is doing. I don't care if you don't love me. I don't care if you don't like me. I don't like myself at times. So what? No big issue with me. This Nobi, this scribe, this man, this messenger, his name is Ezra. I want to qualify and quantify everything he says. But to give status unto him, I want you to turn quickly to the book of Ezra. First Ezra. In chapter 7. Because I'm going to read out what we call the lost Shefa or the lost book. First Ezra, chapter 7, verse 6. And then I'm going to read out of the book of 3rd Ezra, chapter 16, all 73 verses. And I'm going to move somewhat with fervor to expedite, but I must read this for your comforting, Yisrael. But the book of Ezra, Ezra chapter 7 verse 6. It says this in the book of Ezra. First Ezra. It says, this Ezra, he went up from Babel, the city, the place of such confusion and delusion. And it says that this man, he made machia, he made ready. He was prompt. He was skilled with the maturity of knowledge of Torah. He made ready, or the scribe, or in the Torah of Moshe. He was a man that was skilled. He was a man that was machia. He was a man that had a profound knowledge of the Torah of Moshe. Everyone does not possess that. He was a man that had an exceptional skill in the knowledge of the Torah of Moshe, which Yah, the sovereign master of Israel, he had given unto him. Yah must nothan, he must bestow upon a man the knowledge of Torah. This doesn't come by your studying. You can misappropriate what Shaul said to Timothy, to study, to lohag, to show yourself approved of unto Yah. He was telling this young man, you don't resist the elders, men that are students of Torah. So you study the Torah and understand the profound emphasis or its knowledge of Yeshua HaMashiach. So you don't rebuke Ach Obadiah just because of a witness of a lie someone has spoken against him. I know if the whore taught you what that means, throw it out. If you have learned what that meant from the whore, you know it's wrong. That's what he implied. So he said, you must lahag, you must labor, meditate, study the Torah, that these elderly men do not despise your youthfulness. And when you reprove, your reproof will be sound, with great wisdom and knowledge. He was given by Master Yah, had given him, and the king Arashazatah granted him all his requests according to the hand of Yah. His Abba was upon him. Now the hand of Yah was upon Ezra for one thing, to speak unto the nation Yisrael, the elect, those that returning out of captivity. Their minds had been overtaken by the Babel, the Medo-Persian captivity, just like when they came out of Mizraim, wasn't it so? That they began to allude to the flesh pots and what they were able to feed the flesh and to dine in their lusts. And that's the first thing Israel did when it began to segregate and separate itself from the world. It says, I had that. I could have that. If I didn't do this, I could do that. And so they regress backwardsly instead of progressing forwardly. And so the messenger of Yah was sent to warn of a time whereby the offering of Yah is going to be tried by fire. And when the fire begins to burn, then everything that is hidden comes out. When the forest is set of ablaze, everything from the smallest to the greatest try to find a way of escaping. And we have no way of escaping but one way, Israel. And that is through the knowledge of the power of the testimony of Yeshua HaMashiach. It's not through some damn God. It is not through some damn Jesus Christ. Damn Jesus Christ. Damn that lie. It's a lie. It's a lie. And you know no lie is going into the kingdom. It's a lie. It's a shechem. And I vehemently, with all tenacity, well, there are those that you may hurt. Let them be hurt. My mother would put the rod on my arse. It didn't kill me. So what if they're hurt? Grow up. Get over it. I want to begin here in the book of Ezra, third chapter. Ezra, the third book of Ezra, 16th chapter. I wanted to read out of 1st Ezra because we're coming, or we have a commonality with that. I want to read out what we call the lost books or the books that were lost of the Torah. Third Ezra, chapter 16. If you don't have it, just listen. We need to learn how to shemach. You're not going to find it in the KJV. Just listen and hear what the Torah says. It says, as it began on this reading, Ezra chapter 16, verse 1, he uses the word wo or oni. And when Yah implies oni, he is saying there's a cry that it is a wailing that flows from the belly, and it is one that is so bitter. As the daughters of Tizayon must weep for their children, he says, wo oni. It is a cry that is so bitter, but it is one of great passion. It is a passionate cry. He says, woe be unto you. And he identifies the nation Bavel, the nation of this conspicuous hall that we all dwell in. She has confused the dynamics of Yah. She has sent her lies of missionary throughout the world to corrupt and to bring the people in the bondage and captivity, to promote a damn lie and an image that was raised out of hell. The damn Jesus, you can paint in black all you want to. He is still the damn effeminate image. You can paint in brown all you want to. It doesn't mean a damn thing. He's that beast that your mama, when the Jews came to your neighborhood and sold you those books, you saw it on your coffee table. That's who he is. I don't give a damn if you get upset with me. That's Jesus. That's Jesus. You can put him some dreadlocks on and make your skin brown. He is still that same Jesus. That mama had a big picture with him, Martin Luther King, Bobby King, Bobby Kennedy and John Kennedy, all devils. That's what they were. But they had hope in the Kennedys. Damn daddy, that was a thug, a gangster that killed and robbed, broke your damn homes up, drove your daddy to whiskey and your mama to whiskey. And you rejoice in those mamzir, those dirty bastards. I'm going to teach you on this bed. I recall as a young man, I never forget the insurance man. His name was Mr. Mundy. He was a Jew. No Jew going into the kingdom. There is no such identity as a damn Jew. Jews for Jesus. You can be all the Jew you want to, but there is no Jew. There's a tribe of Yehuda. No damn Jew. There's no J for Jesus. How can there be a damn Jew? And so Mr. Mundy was this Spartan young man. I would just look at him because he was always neat and clean. He had a tremendous rapport with my mother. And when she could not pay his insurance, he would pay it for her. But that's his way. He's going to make revenue. And I would watch the Jewish vendors come to our neighborhood and sell us these damn trinkets. And above all, Bibles. With this faggot, effeminate picture of this freak Jesus, and you couldn't even touch that. Mama would have a knism if you touched that. And then they would sell us the picture with Martin Luther King and the Kennedy boys. Then you would have a big old picture with light with Jesus Christ. And that image was ingrained in the minds of your sons and daughters. You can try to eradicate it, but that is the image of Jesus. Don't give me that bullshit. It is. That's the image. That's who he is. You had a little transformation. Say, oh, not to me. Well, Jesus is that. Yeshua is not in that image. Oh, he said shit. Oh, what comes out of your backside? All right. The one says book, book, but that's all right. We are so superior that we think that not me. You're a liar. We all have been subject unto the cruelty of this wicked. We're all Yisrael. Oh, I never thought that way. You liar, you were taught that. It was not you thought that way. It was ingrained in you. In your Baptist, your Methodist, your Pentecostal whorehouses, put it there. It is right, man. And that's the truth. And for us to think that I was not subject unto that, you're just deceiving yourself. I don't care if you're in the farthest of the nation, of the continent of Africa, Europe, Russia, everyone, that's the image. And that's a fact. And when someone sees that image in any other, depicted in another way, they kind of get a little offended, like, that ain't Jesus. You're right, it's not him. So let's get real. Let's get real. Let's quit pretending. We're great pretenders. We're full of falsehood. That is Jesus. It's not Yeshua, but that's Jesus. That's the image of Jesus. That is the superior mindset of Jesus. And that image is purported throughout the world. Just like the big, bubbly, fat hog Santa Claus. Don't tell me you saw him as a dark-skinned man of the diaspora that has just become popular. And it is not received quite well. It is frowned upon. I don't care who the children are, they frown upon that. I don't care who the children are, when they see this Mexican Santa Claus or this black Santa Claus or this Japanese Santa Claus, that is not accepted. By the black folks, it's not accepted. By the Mexicans, it's not accepted. By the whites, it's not accepted. And that's just the truth. You can lie to yourself to give you some kind of appeasing, but it is just the truth. It's strange. It doesn't look right. You don't feel right with that. And that's the truth. I shall, my friend, to die. And let's get real and be honest and just tell the truth. Let's get real. It is right. No doubt about it. Hallelujah. He goes on to say here in the book of Ezra, chapter 16, verse 1, woe to you, Babel, to Asia, and woe to you, Egypt and Syria. He tells them to gird up yourself with cloths of sack and hair. He says, I want you to bakah, I want you to bewail, I want you to weep bitterly. Bewail your children, that's what he says. I want you to cry for your teeth, your babies, the ones that suck your titties, mama. He said, I want you to be well. I want you to baka. I want you to cry with great urgency, with great bitterness. He says, for your children. And he says, I want you to be halah. I want you to be sorry. I want you to beg it. Oh, yeah, please, mama. Yeah, 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 yeah. He says, I want you to beg. We think it's, oh, praise the Lord, Lord Jesus, I love you, hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah, thank you, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. He says, I want you to beg. I want to show you why. This holocaust, this fire that shall burn from the heavens. And we got these dogs today. He says that his pastors, the men that's supposed to be the reaka, they're dogs. He called them greedy dogs. T.D. Jakes is not satisfied with a Bentley. He's not satisfied with the Rolls Royce. He's not satisfied with the Learjet. He's not satisfied with the $100,000 watch. They're never satisfied. They're greedy damn dogs. And we've learned the way of a dog. Hallelujah. Same thing with Benny Hinn and Oral Roberts and Richard Roberts and all these liars. Hallelujah. No, Oral Roberts never performed any organic miracle. It's a lie. There's not one that is pronounced. But he had the folks be guy. Oh, God, see, oh, Roberts. He said, woe unto you. He said, gird yourself, bath of Tizayon. Gird you, ach.
He said, pray for your children. I want you to be halal. He said, I want you to beg. He says, for your destruction is at hand. It is at Yad. It is in the hand of Yeshua HaMashiach. Your destruction is at hand. Verse 3. He says, a sword is sent upon you. Who may turn back the cheret, the sword, the vengeance, the ebra, the death of Yah? He said, a sword is set upon you. And who may turn it back? Who's going to turn it back? Well, I don't believe that he's that way. Well, America, she's a god in the world. Will she burn your babies? You ask the Iraqis, will she burn your babies? You go to Vietnam and ask them, will she drop Agent Orange on you and burn your babies? You go to those of Hiroshima and Nagasaki and see if she will burn your babies. She will burn your babies and you as well. She causes our sons and daughters to burn in their lust for greed and lustfulness. And they raise up these gods, Hammerman. They raise up 50 Cent. They raise up Eminem. And they promote them. And they become icons in your minds. They raise up a dirty whore that's a slut. Sleep with every damn man, every damn woman. And this is what promotes your daughter's beauty. Don't mess with me. How are you doing? This is what promotes the mind of your sons and your daughters. And you, old silly mama, you too. You can't dance for Yah. But what hammer go to shop? We're going to rock down the night. We got the back on the boom. We boom, me boom, me boom. Me, and we talking the talk. We walking the walk and go boom. You get silly, mama. You won't listen to that. Hallelujah. You too, daddy. Moving quickly. He says here in Ezra 16:4, he talks about this ish, a fire is set among you. And he asks the question, he uses the word kabah. Who's going to quench that fire? Who's going to take the fervor of that fire away from the nations and among Yisrael? Who's going to save us? Yeshua utters here so profoundly, as the Nobi Yahaharan speaks of this one that shall come. Listen to what it says in Matithiah, Matthew chapter 3, verse 12. Now, I'm going to integrate different parts of the Torah in this teaching from Ezra. All right, so follow me along and hear. It says in Matithiah, Matthew chapter 3, verse 12, he talks about one who is coming. He says his fan is in his hand. And he will thoroughly purge his floor. How do you purge a house that should be vessels of gold? Arzachin Yarabiyah has, with the preponderance of evidence in Torah, he has warned us repeatedly that it's only by the fire of Yah. He shall purge the floor, the bayat, the house of Yah. He's going to cleanse the floor. And he shall gather wheat into his garner. He's going to gather the remnant of the elect into the place of safety. And that is in the bosom of Yeshua HaMashiach and the power of that testimony. It says this, but he will burn up the chaff, the wicked. And he tells us what kind of fire, with unquenchable fire. Ezra says, who's going to quench the fire? Who's going to quench the fire of Yah's af, his anger, his ebra, the death that flows? You must understand it. Yah makes alive and he kills. He will kill your baby that suck your titties. He will kill your son like a dog. And don't forget, mama, daddy, he will kill you too. Oh, the Baptist taught us, oh, the devil killed my baby. Now Yah said, damn the dirty bastard, kill him. We don't want to think of our God that way, do we? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The fire is unquenchable. It cannot be quenched. It cannot be put out. It shall roar in the anger of Yah for nation and the nations that have wronged his people. They're not getting by. That's why Yisrael, wherever you are, just sit still. You just pray that you can live quiet and peaceful among the heathens. Come out of the world. Segregate yourself. Touch not the unclean things. You're going to be all right. When I finish this, I will show you how all right you're going to be. All right? Hallelujah. It says in verse 5 of Ezra, it says, plagues are sent to you. Who sent the plagues? Who sent the plagues upon Mizraim? Was it the devil or was it Yah? Yah says, plagues are sent to you. And who is he that may drive them away? Who's going to drive away the very anger of Yah? Who's going to destroy the will of Yah? He has sent the plagues. And the plagues shall come upon the land. We see the plagues today. Our young men, this basketball player, Magic Johnson, he has a son that is 6'3", 6'4". He weighs about 300 pounds and he comes out and say, I'm a faggot. And his daddy said, I'm proud of that. You proud of a faggot, son? If I had a daughter that was a slutty whore, I would never let her touch me. You can let yours touch you. She would never touch me. If I had a son that was a faggot dog, I wouldn't even let him in my house. Well, we got to love them. Yeah, I will show you something. He hates them. And because the father didn't love Yah, he will send the curse upon the children of the fathers that hate him down to the third and the fourth generation. You understand? He was not talking to the nations of the Gentiles. He was talking among his people. This man said he's proud that his son, 300 pounds, he's a faggot, that his mind is so twisted and tortured, he doesn't know that his anatomy is that of a man, and your boots pulled dagger daughter looking like a slut with boots on, you tell her she's all right, I'm going to love her anyhow, she will never touch me. Hallelujah. No, get I will. I don't have to worry about mama sneaking in no money or calling her. Why? Because Yah commands the woman to serve her husband, submit unto him, as she submit unto Yah. So don't tell me you love Yah when you can't submit to me. Hallelujah. The Jezebel tell you, baby, you're a woman. You make money too now. That submitting is beautiful. Because I submit myself to her and then she becomes subject unto the protocol of the blessings of Yah. That's why I had to go outside of my marriage for 36 years. I don't need to know anything else. Do you understand? No abuse, you don't abuse. She's the weaker vessel. Hallelujah. Can I read a little bit? Told that my friend. Verse 6. May any man drive away a hungry lion in the woods, or may any quench the fire in stubble when it begins to burn. Can I tell you something? When the fire of his purging is ignited, no one is going to be able to quench it. The prophet Jeremiah gives us a clear picture of that quickly, Jeremiah chapter 4. Jeremiah chapter 4 and verse 4. He tells us to brit milah, or circumcise, cleanse. Jeremiah chapter 4 verse 4. He says, circumcise yourself unto Yah. Take away the filthiness of your vile flesh. Circumcise yourself to Almighty Yahweh. And he said, I want you to take away the foreskin of your heart. I want you to take away all those things that prevent you from thrusting on into the dynamics of the mighty power of Yah. He says, and he identified them, and he did not say Jew. He says, you men of Yehuda, and you inhabitants of Yerushalayim. That's what he said. You're self-righteous. You're not going to let nobody tell you nothing. So you don't gather like they did with Ezra, where he stood in the up in the pulpit and taught the people the Torah. You want to talk about it. You can never have the emunah of Yah but by hearing. Well, I discern some spirit. Well, man, if you discern that weak spirit in you, you've discerned a lot. And woman, if you discern that fallacy in you, with your loud mouthness and shut your mouth, I have no problem saying that. Hallelujah. He said, take away the foreskin of your love, you men of Yahud and your inhabitants of Yerushalayim. Why? He says, unless my Ebra, understand what his Ebra is. It is the wrath of death that flows from the burning inferno of the mind of Yah. He said, and damn it, nothing is going to stop it. He said, I'm telling you, not one damn thing is going to stop it. Your weeping caused the fire to become intense. Ezra says that it was a fire unquenchable. Jeremiah says, he says, lest my wrath comes like a fire and burns so that none can quench it. Because of the evil of whose doing? Your neighbor's doing or your doing? Your own evil doing. He said, because the evil of your doing. He said, I'm going to burn in the power of my Ibra. He said, no man, he uses the word lo. It's not even possible. When Yah says none, no, L-O, lo, there's no possibility. He said, no man can quench it. He said, it's coming because of the evil or the ra, the evil of your doing. Because you have denounced the power of Torah. People will tell you, well, I believe in the whole book, and yet their lives are not, it is not, you don't see the Brit Milah there. You don't see the converting or the changing. We should not look like the world, act like the world. You perhaps should not dress like some cheap Jezebel. You men should dress like men, not with no skin tight, skinny jeans on. No? Dress like a man. I don't want to look like the world. No, I don't want to act like them. And I'm not going to do it. Say, no man can quench the fire. Nobody. It cannot. When Yah rises up, we can pretend all we want to. We can become grandizing and self-supporting in our corrupt, wicked ways. He says, coming because of the evil of your doings. Just pray for her. She needs help. No, honey, you better pray for you. You better learn who you are. We're going to pray for that, sister. No, you are more of a hypocrite than the sister of the ark. You're not dedicated. You're not real. You're phony. You're false. You're not sincere. It is always easy to look at the inabilities of others, but we will never look at our shortcomings. I would be a coward of a man if I stand before you all. And I'm doing things that are full of hypocrisy and pretending. You can't talk like this if you're disingenuous. That's why I will plow our sins into hell. I will expose everything. I don't care if it touch ish, my ish or me. I don't give a damn. This is a wicked nation. This is a wicked generation. He says, damn. Oh, stop it. Hallelujah. Verse 7 of Ezra. He said, may one turn against the arrow that is shot of a strong archer. Can you turn against the arrow? He tells us what to do to withstand the arrows of darkness. The arrows. We have the shield of faith. The helmet of his assurance, his Yeshua. But who's going to quench the fiery darts of Almighty Yah, the arrows of Yah? We can quench all the fiery darts of hell. He says, the mighty one, listen now, this is not the devil. He says that the mighty one, he shall send the nigger. He shall send the plague. You hear them say, this is my nigger. So that's the plague. It is the same word. It is enunciated the same. He will send the nigger. If you learn nothing else, you know what the plagues are that he will send. They are the nigger. He said, I will send my nigger. This is my nigger. He said, I'm going to send the nigger, the plagues, the diseases, the marks of death, and parting away their minds. There's nothing more damaging than a mind become the consortium of every kind of wicked idea and every vile imagination, whereby the power of the light of Yahshua doesn't even shine. That's what we like to talk, don't we? And the Torah tells the wife, she represents the epitome of the assembly. He tells her to be quick to hear. And we as an assembly, we need to be quick to hear. We need men to speak. We need men to stand with authority. Say, shut up. Sit down, woman. Sit down. That's my wife. Then you deal with her like a wife, man. You set her down. Then you tell her to sit down. I've watched men, their wives call themselves leaders. And the men were so effeminate, no nurturing. Give me some water, baby. Hold up, heifer. I'll get you some water because I want to. No. You don't bring me down like that in front of men. And that's what T.D. Jakes and these dogs have taught the people. They pimp the women. They're nothing but million-dollar pimps. Million-dollar pimps. And she's going to get up here and trot out like me. Woman, sit down. Shut your mouth. Your tifferah is not accentuated in that manner. Yours is the quietness. That's what a virtuous woman is, isn't she? Torah talks about a woman that is not a Beth Ula, not a love virgin of a woman, but a virtual woman. She has strength. She has maturity. And when men see her, they say, my, what a woman. Her zakein, her elder, sits in the marketplace with the men. And he debates Torah with them. And when they see this woman, they all say, oh, step back. Step back. Because she's a gem of Yisrael. They see the expression of the Torah of her husband. Now you see a man that is effeminate and weak. And you see the boisterous nature of a woman. I will, man. And so they're training the boys to be, the prisons are filled with boys. I was growing up, come on, in the 60s. Come on, we were fighters. We could fight. I still can throw some blows if I needed to. Yeah. Yahshua is my defense. I don't need to fight no man. Don't be silly. But I still can, I can thump with the best of them. That's a fact. I can. I can put them down viciously. Truth. I can. And so these faggots today, they get it, boom, boom, boom. I got me one. Put me a tattoo right here. It is the truth. In my days, you were a man boy. You fought. You finished, it was over with. Shook hands and went home. It's a fact. Yahweh says, I shall send the nigger, I shall send the death and the plagues. He says, who's able to drive them away? Who's going to deter or cause my plagues to be turned in another direction? Listen to what he tells us. He says, an ish, a fire, shall go forth from his wrath. The fire is going forth from the Ebra, the wrath of Yah. And who is he that may quench it, may stop this wrath? You tell me, the bombs of America, of Russia? Who's going to quench the fire of Yah? He shall cast lightning, and who shall not fear? When the light of the power of Yahshua reflects in us, shall we not fear Yah? Shall we not, Yare, tremble with great reverence before Yah? When a man learns the way of Yah, shall not his ways be a way of strength unto those that are feeble? When a woman is a true path to Zion, shall not her beauty reflect of the great oracles of her mind? We've taken away the beauty of the woman, her sensitivity, her sensuality, her sexuality. It is soul like you sell fat back at the market. And she doesn't cover her beauty for the power of her head. Nobody wants your old woman. Nobody wants your old man. Because that young woman grinned at you, she was just trying to say, hey, daddy, you old man, nice beard. Nobody wants you. Nobody wants you, old woman. Nobody. Nobody. That's why you're trying to impress, to present yourself as being virile. You're not. We're getting older and getting old. I go to bed, my Ema. When I go to sleep, I don't wake up until the next morning. I wake up at 4:45. Okay, what time I go to bed? 4:45. Boom. I don't get up for nothing. Nothing. I just sleep. I like that too. I revive when I get up. Hallelujah. So we not fear Yah. He shall thunder the sevenfold voices of Yah. And when Yah thunder, should we not be afraid? I mean, the word Yire or Yira, it is to have fear of trepidation, to tremble before Yah. And so we have learned, well, he doesn't mean for us to fear him. That's not what he says. The fear of Yah is the beginning of wisdom, because you know what he says, he'll do it. When you spread, when you said, boy, I'm telling you, I will knock you out. Boy, if you do that, I got you. That didn't mean for him to sit down and laugh with you. There's only one that in this hour shall not be succumb unto this. This is the only way we're going to stop the fire of Yah's inferno. Can I show us? What man can express that greater than David? Tehillim, Psalms here. Psalms 112, verse 7. It says this. Psalms 112, verse 7. It says, Yisrael, the nation, the people. Yisrael shall not be afraid of evil tidings, for the things that shall come. We shall not be afraid. Why? His love, his mind, his heart is fixed. Why? Because he's trusting Bodak, trusting in Almighty Yah. That's what warned us when we see the devastation that is coming. We shall not hurry ourselves, neither shall we be afraid, Yisrael, because our hearts are fixed. You know your heart is fixed when you batak. You have confidence in Yah. You trust Yah. You have the assurance of the testimony of Yeshua HaMashiach. You're not so easily moved from Yah's Torah. You're not so easily offended because you love Yah. And those that are easily offended because they have no power of Yah's Ahava. That's why we're so offended, Yisrael. We don't want nobody to correct us because we're easily offended. His heart is fixed. There's an assurance that he is sure at his bosom that all of this is in the hand of Yah. Everything is in the hand of Yah. This has not been orchestrated by the devil. It has not been orchestrated by a miracle or man. It has been done by Yah. Yah set the Pharaoh for one purpose only. For no other purpose, I've raised you up. He used the word kum. I've raised you up. I've exalted you. I've made you mighty, your nation. That I brought my people under your bondage and under your care for you to ostracize and you to malign them. But I raised you up for that. And I'm going to bring it down, man. He brought him down. He brought him down. He says to Russia. He says to those of the genetics of the British. I raise you up. You got nuclear bomb, but your fire is not like mine. You're coming down. He's going to bring her down. I don't care what Mr. Obama says. Her economy is dead. He's going to bring it down. He's going to bring down Britain. He's going to bring down Portugal. He's going to bring down Russia. He's going to bring down Syria. He's going to bring them all down. He's going to bring down that little piece of land we call Israel. And the true lineage of the people shall be restored unto the vital property of the heritage of their father, Abraham. Yitzchok and Yaakov. Going home, the journey of Yah, going home. good heart on the journey of your, yes I am. When all Israel shall return to their roots, going home to Yerushalayim, we're going, yes I am. Going home soon and it won't be very long. That's all right, see, get the dancing. Well, that's fantasizing, but yet we fantasize, don't we? You think you're going to be rich. You think you're going to win the lottery. But though devil born his manipulation, that fellow that was $27,000 behind in child support, he won the mega, didn't he? I guarantee the women are crawling on him now. Demons crawling out of the covert. He's going to spin it like a fool. And he's going to go broke. It is the truth. Yisra'el, David says, shall not be afraid of the things that we perceive as evil. Why? Because our hearts are levi'im, our heart, our love is fixed. And the only way your heart is fixed, you must trust in Torah. You must trust in Torah. You can have no living Torah without the testimony of Yeshua HaMashiach. You can have none of that. And so you must go back to the Bereshit, the beginnings, to understand the beauty of Torah. Hallelujah. You that are listening, I have a message on the abomination that make desolate. Please, Aksimeon, your play that after this teaching today. The abomination that make it desolate. You need to hear that. Our hearts are fixed. We have the assurance, the uprightness, the confidence of Torah. Ezra cries deeply in verse 11, Yah shall threaten, and who shall not be utterly beaten to the powders at his presence? It says that the earth shall raga, it shall quake, it shall quiver, it shall be removed from its place with the agitation of the voice of Yah. And the foundations thereof, the sea arises up with waves from the deep, and the waves are troubled. The fish thereof before Yah and before the splendor of his power. He gives us a strong warning in verse 13. For mighty with great power. For strong is his right hand. Who is the right hand? Of Yahushua HaMashiach. For strong is his right hand that bends the bow. You tell me Yahushua is going to bend the bow? He's going to kill your babies too. Yes. Your Jesus is not going to do it, but Yahushua is going to kill them. Yes. Strong is the hand of him that bends the bow. His arrows that he shoot, they are sharp. And shall not miss. They are being begotten to be shot. Where? Into the ends. The Achariz. The Achariz. See where the arrows of Yah have been shot? Are we not in the ends of the earth? Are we not in the ends of the earth? What is the arrows, or what are the arrows of Yah? How are they defined? Can they be defined in Torah? Well, I will define them for you. Can I do that? The messenger, Jaur, writes here in Ibarim, in the book of Hebrews, Hebrews chapter 4, verse 12. It says, for the Torah, the Dabar, the Dabarim, the word of Yah, Hebrews 4, 12. For the word of Yah is quick, it is alive, and it is powerful, sharper than any two-edged sword. Yeah. That is what been shot in the end of the earth. Piercing even the dividing of Shana of the Nefesh and the Ruach, of the joints of the Marah. It is the discerner of the thoughts and the intents of the heart. That's the arrow. That's the weaponry of Yah's word. That it cuts down into the depths of our wicked hearts and destroy this image of your God, this vile demon power you call a God, this devilish thing that you've created in your mind. That satisfy you in all of your lustful desires. That's your God. Hallelujah.
Yisraya, there is only one profound message that must be taught in this hour.
Hallelujah.
Turn quickly to Revelation. I'm going to finish this today. Revelation chapter 14. This is the only message that should be taught. No other message. It says in Revelation chapter 14, verse 6, this is the message of this hour. Yokohan said, I saw another melach fly. Revelation 14, 6, I saw another melach fly in the midst of Hashemaim. It says, does it say everlasting in your translation? Does it say everlasting? And most it would say everlasting, everlasting gospel. Does it say that in your translation? But it is the everlasting bezorach, the everlasting teaching. This is the everlasting teaching. See, what Christianity has done is said, this is the everlasting teaching, that we teach about our Jesus and he's going to save everybody. But that's not what the Torah says. This is what it says. He says, having the everlasting message, or the message that is olam viat, the everlasting message in the heavens, having the everlasting message to what? To preach. Does it not say that? Yeah. To Mizorah, to pour out in the bosom of man, to preach unto them where they dwell upon the earth. We are the dwellers of the earth. We are in the world, but we're not of the world. And to every nation, this is the truth that must be taught to every nation, and kindreds and tongues and people. Amen. What is the message? Saying with a loud voice, fear Yah. We've been taught not to fear Yah, have we not? The Baptist taught me not to fear Yah. The Baptist taught me not to fear Yah. The Pentecostal. That's the message of truth. Fear Yah. Fear Yah. Fear Almighty Yahweh. Fear Yah. And give honor unto him. Give kabod unto Almighty Yah. For the hour of his mishpatim, the hour of his judgment, it is come, it has entered in, it has entered through the veil. And it tells us to shahat, to worship him that made heavens and the earth and the sea and the fountains of the water. Are we worshiping Yah? We're damn liars. We don't worship Yah. We got this religious persona. That's the message. We don't know how to worship Yah. And that's the truth. And that's the truth. He would come before us and tell us to sing and let everything have breath praise him. You do that? Yeah. Come on, be honest. Talk to me. Yeah. We don't do that. Yeah. This is the message that must be taught. Well, the message of salvation, that's what the Shalishach did. They went everywhere and declared the power of that truth unto every nation. They went everywhere. Yeah. Won the nation of Israel. They won his people. That's why Ezra talks about Asia. Because he says, I'm going to rip you apart, Asia. You know, we are so senile in our pompous ways that we hear something that is the truth. We don't like it. We can't concur with it. If someone, when someone tell you the truth of you, or you trying to tell someone the truth of them, then, well, what did I do? You know what you did, liar. You know what you did. Where's the evidence? These are my evidence here. That's the message that should be preached. Your sons and daughters, mama, you don't fear Yah. You don't fear Yah. You don't even fear your husband. You don't even give him honor. Hallelujah. That's why Yah commands the woman to honor, kabod, to gadan, to give him great honor. You honor some wicked bastard on the street, you won't honor your man? No, you're not going to do that with me. I know you about to say, bless you. You're not going to do that with me. And then he commands me to love her. He said, mamas haven't really taught you how to love. And don't dispel his actions and his activities, not his love. Does Yah receive you today? Then he put the rod to your arse, doesn't he? Fick, fick, fick. He tells her to honor me. To honor. And he said, love her. So when you love someone, you don't lie to them.
swear I've never lied to her. I can say that with all, I've never lied to my wife. Never. 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 Never.
Have I lied to others? Sure, I have. So have you. I've done everything any man has done. Filthy, adulterous, a liar, dirty dog. If I break the least of one of these commandments, I'm guilty of them all. I don't hold myself in no esteem, or you should not, because you say, well, I've been faithful to my wife 13 years. So what? So what, man? You haven't been with her 30 years or 25. So what? So I've broken every sin, every commandment in the book. How many times? Oh, I'm glad that only he knows the numbers. I'm glad I don't have to keep count of that. It's the dumb of Yeshua, HaMashiach. So you have no grandizing platform because you haven't stole or you haven't done that. You're still a wretched thing undone. That doesn't qualify you, quantify you either to give you some kind of place of esteem. I'm this way. I know you are, friend. Moving quickly. Hallelujah. Ezra 16:14. He said, behold, the plagues are sent and shall not return again until they come upon the earth. The fire is kindled. It shall not be put out till it consume the foundations of the earth. I wish I had time to speak on every verse of this. I can show you the preponderance of evidence throughout Torah that everything Ezra says here in this writing, it is of essence, great truth, and revelation. He says, like as an arrow, which is shot of a mighty archer, return not backwards. What a man matters the water, when he shoots that arrow, it doesn't return back. You hear the arrow doesn't do like a boomerang. When Yah shoots the arrow, it does not return backwards. Even the plagues that I sent upon the earth shall not return. Now, did Yah say that? It's either the book of Ezra is the truth or it is a lie, right? To give us concrete evidence that what Yah says is of great validity. If you look quickly here in the book of Yeshaya, Isaiah chapter 55, verse 11. Isaiah 55, verse 11. Is this the truth here? Does this not witness as to what Ezra just said? He said, I'll send forth. And he gives us a taz nuth, a pattern. I'll send forth the arrow. It has gone out, it shall not return. He says in Isaiah 55:11, Yah says to Yisrael, so shall my word be that goes out from out of my mouth. These are his words that went out of the mouth of Ezra, wasn't it? He said, it shall not return unto me void. Just like the arrow has gone, the word shall not return without accomplishing what is intended. When you send forth an arrow from a mighty archer, you intend to kill. He said, my word will not return back unto me void, but it shall accomplish that which I please. So when Yah sent forth the plagues and all that, it's going to accomplish what he pleases. When the mighty archer, he is an archer, isn't he? When the mighty hunter, when he sent forth the arrow, his word is a flame of fire, Yisrael. It is a powerful sword. And when he began to use that, it's going to accomplish what his word said it was going to accomplish. It is a holocaust beyond proportion. Death shall prevail. The fire of his wrath shall burn, and the house shall be purged, Yisrael. You're not getting out of this unscathed. You can continue your little worldly pursuits and pretend. Can I tell you, this is one thing about my natural kinsmen, even as an ignorant young man, they were very careful with me. I didn't laugh in the damn dens of folly. I didn't go to their fat back chicken houses and eat their fried biscuits and their fried catfish. I was telling the man the other day, I said, I don't even know my sister's children. They have children. I don't even know them. He said, doesn't trouble you. I say, for what? Why? He raised them up for hell. And they have children. I'm a great, great, great uncle. Don't even know that, who I'm a great, great uncle to.
I don't know my oldest brother's children.
If I saw them today, I could not identify them. Maybe the oldest son, the oldest daughter, I would not know her from a bullfrog.
Your life is lonely. I'm happy.
That's why I sing, because I am Esha. Oh, I sing, because I am Yafash. I am free. Oh, his eyes watches over me. And because of that, I am so happy. I'm happy. I'm looking to see Yeshua HaMashiach. I'm not worried about her children, my brother's children. I gotta make it into the kingdom. Oh, I must make it. Yeah, I got to save me from this wicked world. I'm not worried about them. They know where I'm at. You ought to come. Don't come dressing like a whore, sister. Put on some clothes. Don't come here like that. They know. That's why they don't come around me. Hallelujah. He shall not sit out his Torah and return out of his mouth void, but it will go accomplish that which is pleased. It shall prosper. You tell me plagues, it shall prosper in the things whereunto I send it. He said, I shall send the plagues, did he not? And it's going to prosper. It's going to work the havoc, the death of Yah. Man thinks that he is going to dethrone Yah. So he has created all kinds of lords and all kinds of gods. He have created a Holy Ghost, which is a damned of a lie. You blaspheme and damn the Holy Ghost. Now, how about that? Now, if I'm blaspheming, you don't even know what the word blasphemy is. You blaspheme the Ruach of Yah. Because the Ruach of Yah, when he comes, Yahshua, when he comes, he will not speak of himself. He will not speak of his power. It is one of his powerful, most powerful principles to lead and guide us into all what truth. What is truth? Torah. That's what Imat is. It's Torah. Torah. So this damn Jesus is not guiding me into the truth of Yah. And took me down the pathways of lies and corruption. And we hold on to that lie and afraid to say. I'm not afraid. You all don't have to say it. I'll say it, all right? I'll stand before Yah. You know, you're brazen. Oh, I tell you, kill me. I tell him, kill me. I mean that. But he knows. I'm not afraid to die for what? You're going to die. As pretty as you are, you're going to die. As old as you got, as young as you are, you're going to die. You can beg and cry, I don't want to die, you're still going to die. It is appointed unto every man to die once. And then after the judgment, we better prepare for death. In that death, we have life. I'm living to live. I don't know about you, but I'm living to live. Moving expeditiously, quickly. Verse 17, woe is me. Who will deliver me in those days? Who's going to deliver you? We are wretched people. Woe is me. You always talk about woe is her or him, but woe is me. The beginning of sorrows and great mourning. The beginning of famine and great death. Now, this is what went out of the mouth of Yah. He did not just say death, but he said great death. The beginning of famine, not the famine of the eating of the bread. We have more bread than we can eat. We're fat, we're lazy, we're out of shape. But the famine is to hear the assurance of Yah's Torah. Yes. This is coming out of Yah's mouth. He said the beginning of wars and the power. Yahshua talk about in the day of great tribulation, we will hear of rumors of wars and all kinds of diverse different things shall transpire. Wars and the power shall stand in fear, and the great kings and the leaders of the nations, they shall stand in fear. Why? The beginning of evils, of Ra. The thought, the conscience of man was only evil continuously. When we think about the things that revolve in our mind, are they not evil things? Come on, let's be honest. Our thoughts are evil. Our thoughts do not promote the power of Yah. We relegate Yahshua to a backwards place in the midst of the crowd of the wicked. We grin and skin and act like jackasses like them. And that's just the truth. We have no fear of Yah. We are just as phony as they are phony.
And we have this amber of this pretense. You don't even mention the name of Yah, but you mention the name of your damn gods and your folly and your damn stupidity. And that's a fact. They don't have no family reunion to talk about Yah. They lust and get drunk. Feeling on your wife. That's my cousin. He doesn't give a damn about your wife. They go to bed with each other, cousins and kinfolks. You say what you want to. They look at your baby daughters and lust after them and get close to them. And you go to these dungeons of hell and darkness. You think it's right, don't you? Sure we do. That's my cousin. So what? What shall they do? What shall I do when these evils shall come? What are we going to do, Yisra'iyah? What are we going to do when this evil shall come? Behold, famine and plagues, tribulation and anguish are sent. You see what it says? It has sent as a scourge. That's why Yah sends that, Yisra'iyah. This is for you. He sends this to shutate, to cleanse. They are sent as a scourge. For amendment, to get it right. You all don't believe that? Well, I'll read this and see if you believe this in the book of Hebrews. It says, Hebrews 12:6, for whom Yah loves, he chastens and scourges every son whom he receives. He sends the scourge or the shu'it. He sends that, Yah does, for an amendment, to get us right, to amend our ways before Yah, to get it right, Yisra'iyah, that we make sure we're walking in the light of the Torah. For our sake, Yah says in verse 20, Ezra, but for all these things, Yah help us. For all these things, they shall not turn from their wickedness, nor be always mindful of the scourge. Have you ever spanked your child? You put them down 5 minutes later, they're doing the same thing, are they not? And that's the way we are. We're not even mindful of the shu'its of Yah when he scourges us. We hear messenger of Yah scourge us. We're not even mindful of what he said. We hear it and we go out and act like fools again. We're not even mindful. That's why Yisra'iyah is coming upon us. You can listen to the lies of the Christian horse and you're going to be raptured out. You're not going to do anything. It's a lie from hell. You can appease yourself in your religious folly and frivolity. Go to your Baptist whole house and sit down tomorrow and think it's all right. You keep your little phony Shabbat. You go to mama's house and she cooking her sacrifice to a Baptist Sunday God. And you eating the fried chicken. She seasoned the greens with fat back and all. Well, just don't eat the fat back, baby. Just eat some greens. Nah. I'm not even eating in your house. Not me. You can. I will not eat in her house because I know she used fat back and ham hocks and fried catfish. You can. I will not. Hallelujah. Listen to this in verse 21. Behold, food. Now, these people telling you to buy gold, these lying dogs, hear me, Yisra'iyah. Do we have anyone listen or everyone has abandoned me today? I know my Zachin, Charles Davis out there in California, and all of those that are gathered with him. So they all have fallen off? All right, we have a few. Hallelujah. Listen, these liars tell you to buy gold and store up food. Listen to this. We're talking about the Ach Arith, the last days. It says this. He says, behold, verse 21, food shall be so cheap upon the earth. Food is not cheap now, is it? It shall be so cheap upon the earth that they shall think to themselves, that this is excellent. Oh, I can buy fat back a dime a pound now, baby. It's going to be so cheap that they're going to think that, sure, this is the hand of my Jesus Christ. This is the hand of God. I love the God. I love God. I love the Lord God. He said, food will be so cheap. It will be so inexpensive. And these liars telling you to buy gold. Don't buy no gold if you don't love Yah. Just whatever you have, you can buy half of a hog for a few pennies. You can go down to the market and get all the catfish you want. And the romaine oodle noodles, you can get them all with your pork fat and all that in it. Hallelujah.
You tell me you know the clean things of Yah.
Well, baby, just let her eat that. No, you don't bring that in my house. It's unclean. We have a book on many of the unclean things. You want to write, send us an email and we'll send it to you. Behold, food shall be so cheap upon the earth that they shall think themselves it is a tough case. And even then shall evil grow upon the earth. Even though food is cheap, they're getting greedy. Shall the evil proceed? He said, evil shall grow upon the earth, swords, famine, and great confusion. They will be delirious under delusion because they receive not the love of the Torah. This is what Shaul says in Thessalonica. Because they receive not the love of the truth, Yah shall send them strong delusions that they all should be damned. So that's why I use the word damn this wicked nation and damn your wicked ways, because Yah is going to damn you. When he cusses, well, if Yah used the word damn in Shaul, I can use it too. Hallelujah. He shall send great confusion. They shall be consumed by the nature of Bethel. For many of them that dwell upon the earth shall perish of famine. They shall not hear the Torah of Yah. Their mind shall not be sound. Listen to this. And the others that escape of hunger shall the sword destroy. So who is doing this? Is this America? Does America send the sword? She has the weapon to burn you up. I give you the clear truth on where it comes from. Jeremiah tells me, Jeremiah chapter 15, verse 3, Yah says, and I will appoint. Now that's having power. He said, and I will appoint over them four kinds, says Yah. He says, I'm going to appoint over the sword to kill them, to muth, to Mavi, that they die prematurely. I will put the sword over them to kill them. He says, I'm going to put the wicked dogs of the preachers. He said, these preachers are greedy dogs. The dogs to tear them, the fowls of Hashemah, and the beasts of the earth to devour and to shohath, to destroy them. These appointments are from Yah. He has appointed the sword, death. He is the one that appoint that. Yisra'yah, there's a reason that the food is going to be so cheap. I'll get there. When these nuclear bombs fall, it's going to destroy the whole ecosystem. And those that shall pine away in their hunger, we're eating, but we're not satisfied, are we? We're eating more food, we all are. We're eating more food, but yet our bellies are not satisfied with that. There's nothing of nutritional value in it. That's why you grow some food. All of you that listen, put a raised bed behind your house and grow some food. Mama, you don't work, grow food. Bend your back. Get the damn television out of your house. Crack the monitor for MySpace and all that trash. And bend your back some. If he's out laboring, bend your back. Grow something. Put something on the table like Granny when she worked in the cotton fields every day. She had a garden on the side of the house. She put them that chicken and them collards and them and all them turnips on that morning. She kindled the fire right. And when she got back that evening, it was done. And she labored in the fields all day long. And when Papa came in a little bit later, she gave him a basin of water he could wash off his neck. And he sat down. She put the cornbread in there and he was able to eat. Sit home and your mind is consumed as a whore turned, as the world turned, as the sluts and the faggots unite. And you give your time only that you're going to hell, you dirty slut of a Jezebel. Yeah. You fat beast of hell. Watching television all day. Yeah. I don't care if you don't love me. You don't love Yah, so I know you can't love me. I messed up. I'm not going to finish all this, but I'll give you enough that you can go on and proceed. This is a powerful chapter. I'll come back and finish teaching it one day. All right. I got to move on after the Shabbat. I must teach on Hanukkah, the times, the season, the Moed, and how we determine the Moedim, the feast days. You got people that don't even know even the order of the feast days of Yah, and they know more than anyone. They don't even know how to determine. I asked these leaders, how did you get, if the seventh month began in October last year of Sukkah, how did you get a first month in March?
Well, this shows up when you see the barley.
There's nowhere in Torah. There's nowhere where our forefathers looked to barley and looked at the signs of the heavens. There's nowhere in Torah. There is nowhere there is a damn Jewish lie. It is of hell. You cannot find one tasneath, my Beth. If you do, please, show me. Show me. You cannot find one place.
Well, the word of Obi means barley. I don't give a damn. The month of Tammuz means God too.
And so everyone knows everything and they don't know anything. Then you got the compadres say, well, you can't keep a Pesach, but in Yerushalayim. Well, first of all, we're not making a bohir. Are we Mazakein, our leader? We're not making no sacrifice. Yah says you can only sacrifice the Pesach in Yerushalayim with his name. He commands us to observe Pesach on the Mu'adim. I got something for them all. I'm coming to L.A. in June. You better be ready. Hallelujah. Oh, you Israelites to think you are come. My message shall be Esav, Edomi, the nation, the people, and the Mai. How about that? You can't teach that by reading. It takes an intense labor. Can I proceed? Okay. Hallelujah. Yah is the one that appoints this over us. Verse 23 of Ezra 16:23, and the dead shall be cast out as dung, and there shall be no man to comfort them. The earth shall be shamath, it shall be wasted, and the city shall be cast down. Listen in verse 24. There shall be no man left to till the earth. You tell me no one tills the earth? We don't have that today, do we? Nobody wants to till the earth. There shall be no man. It takes a man to till. A boy cannot till. A lazy, obese man cannot till. And there shall be no ish left to till the earth and to sow it. If there is no sowing, then there is no power of his fruit. The tree shall give fruit. They shall give the berry. But who shall gather them? Who's going to gather them? Who's gathering the fruit of Yisrael today? Who's making sure that the trees are pruned and there's fruit? And we're gathering. You see a precious brother, you gather that into your heart. And you take that trait. Mark the perfect man. Walk the man that is tall, being that is complete. For the end of that man, the gates of that man, it is shalom. We don't mark a perfect man. We don't mark a man that is true with God. Who's going to gather the fruits? The grapes shall be ripened. And who shall press them for the yayin or tread them for the wine? For all places shall be shimama. It shall be desolate of men. All places shall be desolate. There's a reason why it shall be desolate. Because Yah warns his nation here in the book, the writings of Leviticus 26:33. Leviticus 26:33, Yah says, and I will... I will scatter you among the nations, the Goyim, the heathens. Yah says, and I will draw a sword after who? You, Yisrael? That's what he says, doesn't he? Leviticus chapter 26, 33. He said, and I will draw a sword after you. He said, and your land shall be desolate, and your cities shall be wasted. Our cities are wasted, and that's what they do. They waste the young men away. He said, I'm going to draw the sword after you, Yisrael. Why? Because we have defied the Torah. We won't denounce their Jesus. We won't denounce their false writings of what they call the New Testament. We have a Brit Hadassah. We have a covenant or a relationship with Yah through the offering of Yeshua, but it is a lively one. It's not just a reading of something, but it's a lively one. The life of what? Of Torah, of what Moshe said, what Obadiah said. That's what it is. He said, I'm going to send the sword after you. He said, in your place of your dwelling shall be desolate. Our homes are without life of interaction, without the true love of Yah. We don't have that in our homes. We don't have no comradeship. So Yah commands us as a nation to learn how to love each other. We don't know how to love each other. Yisrael will lie on Yisrael. They will despise Yisrael. They will come against Yisrael. They will do Yisrael wrong. But they will uphold a standard to the wicked and try to show the wicked they're right. Yah says, as much as we have opportunity to do tov unto all men, but especially Yisrael. If we can't forbear the sins of Yisrael, if I can't forbear the sins of a little thing like that or her sins, come on, Yisrael. What am I if I can't forbear her sins? Has she lied? Your mama has lied. I have lied. We all have lied. No different. Your daughter has lied. She lied to you, daddy, and she's lied to you, mama. You can't judge someone. Don't you know that's you hypocrite? You that judge your ak, your whole, and you do the same, you damn devil of hell. You wicked beast. I judge you severely, and I'm doing what I'm judging you of. That's wickedness. I'm so glad Yah is fair. And I'm glad he's not like me. Yoshua looks at me and says, what a fool. He's a fool, Yah. I buy he's a fool. Look at that man. He has no decorum. He has no beauty. And he is right. He has none of that. Yah said, that's all right. Let him go. He'll come to the knowledge. Hallelujah. Ah. Praise Yah. Praise him. So that one man shall desire to see another and to hear the voice. He says, we're coming to a time that, you know, they tell you to trust no man. Don't you hear that, don't you? You have learned that from the religious whore. Do you trust the doctor when he tells you what you got? Sure you do. I will. He tell you got sacroronitis. Give some kind of Greek Latin terminology. You buy it. You buy, yeah, you go to a drugstore and you fill up on the drugs. Don't tell me you don't buy it. Hypocrite. But you trust him. You trust him laying you open, cutting you open, and going, you trust him with your baby. You trust him cutting your baby open. You cut your husband open. You trust him seeing your wife naked. I don't want to see your wife naked. I don't want to see you naked, man. And yet we don't trust nobody, but you trust you, don't you? You stupid man. Hallelujah. That's what the enemy is trying to do, to destroy the power and the image of man. He's a powerful thing. And I love you, Baptist Zion. I love you, whereby I respect you greatly. Don't think you can sit down and laugh with me. Don't think you can sit down and ask me questions. I won't allow it. You listen, you'll learn. All right? I don't play with women. I don't want to see your eyes, the print of your body parts. I don't want to see your titty nipples shining through your blouse. I don't want to see that. But don't think that you can come and just sit down and we're going to congregate and just talk. That's not going to be. Shut your mouth. Talk to your husband. Talk to the bath of Tizayon. And don't come here trying to think you're going to dominate and tell us. And you tell us nothing. All right? That's a fact. I'm not going to let him do that.
You keep Pesach by tradition.
Oh, stop it, man. What are traditions? Hallelujah. Some questions I don't even answer. I don't even waste my time because they're stupid.
No stupid question. We've been taught that.
It's a stupid question when you have already determined your answer. And you want to ask me a question to try to challenge me. You're stupid. Yah calls us sottish, doesn't he? So we're stupid. We all are. I'm not stupid. Oh, you know you're stupid. You might as well hate me. Hallelujah. Verse 28, for of the city there shall live. Now this is profound. Yeah, I like this. Ezra 16:28. For of the city there shall be 10 left. Listen now what it says. And two of the field, which shall hide themselves in the thick groves and in the clefts of the rock. Two of a field now. There is no kind of connotation of that reveal us to us in the Brit Hadas, is it? Well, I'll direct your attention there to Lucas, the book of Lucas, Marcus Lucas, Luke chapter 17, verse 34, to give validity of what this messenger of Yah prescribed to us. Now, you don't get this with one of those kinds of what they call Bibles that correlate scripture. No, this comes through tenacity and the intervention of the Ruach, all right, seeking. It says in Lucas chapter 17:34, Yeshua said, I tell you that in that night there shall be two men in the bed. Did he not say two men in the field, Ezra? He said there shall be two men in the bed. One shall be taken, it talking about the strength of Yehuda and the strength of Ephraim, the broken house or the segregated house of Israel. He said, and when he talks about there are 10 tribes, so when Ezra talks about there shall be 10, he's talking about the 10 northern, the kingdom tribes of Israel. Listen, I tell you in that night there shall be two men in one bed. Yeshua says that the Abana will ikat. We have one house, one resting place. And one shall be taken, and the other shall be left. We see it today. Yehuda taken by his own deceit, and Ephraim by his own arrogance and his own veracity. Because Ephraim, Yisrael, is a nation of people that prevail. We prevail in all captivity. We prevail in knowledge and strength. We produce the excellence of the power of the testimony of Yeshua. And it talks about this two women in verse 35. Two women shall be grinding together, and one shall be taken and another's left. I know this has the great implication of the times of the Zara, the great trials of tribulation, but it also has the implication of the mindset today as well. You have two hold together, they're working, and one's mind is taken with lies and deception and every kind of corruption, and one's mind is left on the ways and the truth of Yah. Same thing with Ak. They're working together, they're laboring in the field, and the other is being taken by his own corruption, his own wickedness. His mind is drawn to the world, and the other will say, I love Yah. You can pretend all you want to and keep pretending and think you have something and think you're going into the kingdom. Many shall come to me and say, Yeshua, did I not cast out demons in your name? Did I not do mighty works in your name? He's going to say, depart from me. Look at the word he uses. He calls them workers of what? Iniquity. He uses the word ovon, doesn't he? We understand what the word ovon means. He stole some. That's not what ovon is, ovin. It is the perverse wickedness of one's mind. Whereby there is no law for Torah. That is what the word ovon is. It is the denouncing of the Torah, whereby one's mind is bewitched, and they walk in every kind of damnable lie there is. And they love lies. They love lies. They love the false men. Isn't that amazing? Some of these folks listen, won't even send a dime to him. But they listen. They don't realize it costs money. What wicked individual. Yeah, I say it. You can't go to Walmart broke, honey. That's a fact. Shaul says this in Galatians chapter 3. Galatians chapter 3 verse 1. He says, oh foolish. He uses the word evil. Don't call my brother foolish. He calls them foolish. That's what a mind of iniquity is. He calls them, O foolish Galatia. He uses the word, who hath bewitched you? What kind of witchcraft? Jesus has bewitched you. The Holy Ghost has bewitched you. Who have bewitched you that you should not obey the truth? What is the truth? The Torah is the truth. What has bewitched you so and caused you to succumb unto lies that you cannot obey the truth, whose eyes Yeshua HaMashiach has been evidently set before impale among you? You don't see the power of Yeshua in your Ach and your Chutzah? Who has bewitched you? Who has used the power of sorcery? Not that your heart deceive you, but when one is bewitched, they cannot obey the truth. When one is bewitched, they cannot obey the truth. That's why your mama raised hell when you talk about Yeshua. You're trying to convince her. Her mind is bewitched. And if you think she's going to go into the kingdom, you are a damn fool. She's going to die in her sins. But baby, I was born a Baptist. You were born what you were. You were made a Baptist with lies. And a Methodist by lies. You're foolish. You cannot obey the truth. Your Sadiq is an everlasting Sadiq, and his Torah is the truth. There's only one truth. You cannot correlate anything just in the new. You got to go back to the beginning, and then you bring it all onto the Brit Hadassah. The Brit Hadassah speak volume of what is. So, folks, that's why these whole houses today they have in mime and cultural things they call art, and people dancing, women getting up and just miming, and cats getting up and miming with these demon faces on. That's what they're doing today. Sure it is. And the leaders don't want to challenge the people, so they want to sit down and they form this little semicircle like the Pharisees and the scribes, and everybody got a little input. No, your input is the life you live, honey. It's not your talk. It's the way you walk. You understand? When I go somewhere, it's not my talk. It's the way I walk. I will come on. It's not what I say. It's when I enter into the place. You're not dealing with some kind of French fry daddy. I don't care who you are. Woman, your beauty is not what you say and what you think you know, your intelligentsia. You have, what is intelligentsia? You got a little piece of that, a little piece of that, a little piece of that. You think you're smart? You're silly. You are silly as hell. I'm an intelligent, what is intelligence? You know a little bit of that, you know a little of that, you know that. Can't even quote a scripture. And you think you're intelligent. I educated. Oh, they mess you up. Go to school, get a good education, and get a good job. That's all my mother told me. You might as well love me. I'm not going to finish this today, but that's all right. I'll get back. There are some things I want to finish up in this, though. It shows us a time of a great agony and great sorrow, great oppression. Yahshua sent forth his fire, Yisrael. And I don't want you to be discouraged. I want to close with that. This is a powerful message here. I don't even like the way that I'm dealing with it because the nuances of it is so great. Each verse should be explained by reference of Torah. So I said I explain each five verses to the people and show them the correlation. You must understand that I just woke up this morning and said, okay, give me some Torah. Yeah, give me some Ketuvah. And I just, all right. Hallelujah. That's how this was done. But it's a very dynamic message of truth. And this is the only thing that's going to cleanse us. Don't. You can pretend all you want to and think you're right. But we're not right. Every time we come into his house, he's going to scourge us and correct us. Because we've been quite filthy. That's why we don't bring the filth in. We just leave it out there. And then we set before him, he began to work on us. We need strong men. We need government, men of strength. Men that have backbone. Men that have the strength of Torah at their back. Old man telling me on the way over here, come on, he's getting old. He said, I'm going to stand beside. We're going to walk this thing together. I said, I like that, old man, because in the midst of the battle, I don't want you behind me. I want you right there so we can fight together. Pull out your sword. You may can't swing like me, but just swing and that's enough. Yeah, pull out that word of Yah. Pull out the Torah. Pull it out of your bosom. Your grammatics may be broken. Your English may not be as refined as the next man, but that's all right. You know it's the truth. Yeah. Why? Because you're hearing
And when you hear, you continue in that word. And then you shall hear that, you shall experience the truth. And the power that shall make you free. Come on, Yisrael. You never get the dynamics of Yah's truth by talking. Emunah comes by Shemech, hearing to obey. When you got people want to talk, it's because you got rebellion there. And everyone wants to defend their way. Well, I don't see, well, you know, I know it said that, but I don't think it's that. Shut up, shut up, shut up. So how does one in a crazy mood, any of you all, don't raise your hands. You've never been moody or crazy? Okay. You walk into Yah's house and you've got contention in you and you call yourself going to explain Torah to someone. You're a silly woman. Stop, man. You just raised hell with your husband all last night. You abused the woman verbally and you're going to come in and try to tell somebody something. You liar. And you're going to judge everybody by that spirit that's in you. And you're going to condemn them because you have the sense of condemnation, man. You're a coward. If anything you do, you confess your sins and your faults. And then you have the effectual fervent prayer of those that if they're fervent in truth, and then they pray and say, help him, oh, help Reaga, hallelujah. That's what you do. Hallelujah. I want to move a little farther. I'm going to close in a moment. There's just so much, Yisrael. Hallelujah. The last verse is verse 36 in Lucas. Two men shall be in the field, and one shall be taken, and the other shall be left. You know what? Ezra 16:71. Yah says the Norbi say in this time, the men they shall be as they shall be mad. We have a mad generation. It's madness among the people. He talks about how the madness shall be upon the people because of the approaching terror of Yah that he has commanded to be. He has raised up the nations. He has raised up America to proliferate bombs. He raised up Mr. Barack Hussein Obama to be the deceitful, grinning devil and liar he is, to deceive the masses of you folks that say that, quote, I got me a black man, unquote, in the White House. And you went out and wasted Yah's time to vote for that devil. Yah was going to put him in place. Well, forgive me, Yah. I'm absolutely wrong. He put it in the hearts of the people to vote for Mr. Obama because that's his man. Just like Mr. Bush, just like Mr. Clinton, just like the Bush before him, just like Mr. Reagan, all of them, he put it in their hearts, all right? He puts it in the hearts of the people. How do I know? Because when Herod says, who do you want? Do you want Barabbas, the insurgent, the wicked one? Or this one you call Yeshua HaMashiach? And they cried, give us Barabbas. And we say, give me Mr. Obama. And as far as all the social programs, the employment is dismal. The jobs are growing for $6 an hour, $7 minimum wages. How does a woman in New York City with four babies, she's struggling in the cold. How does she even pay rent and live in a place like that? And the difficulties and the anxiety and the anguish on a woman like that. As someone in LA. In a nation that turns its back on the poor, on the oni, the dal, woe unto that nation. Woe unto it. When you got rich bastards that have created the evil in the land, there's a sore evil in the land, mainly wages kept back by the owner to their own destruction. They know you're making them $100 an hour, they give you seven. That's wicked. It's wrong. And you're too damn greedy and lustful. You're too damn dumb to say, let's take all of our monies and put it together. And we do this for the nation as a whole. You want your own little damn house. That's a shack. You got to pay somebody to come do some repairs. You want your own little damn car.
You don't give a damn about nobody. You don't love nobody. That's why you want yours. It's going down to the dust of the earth. You're not leaving anything but a heritage of the strength of the testimony of Yeshua to your children. You think you're leaving land? I said to my Ishaw the other day, I said, I watched this old house as you came down the road on the right. That old man, I say, if he could come back, he would put a stake on all them young'uns. He labored all his life for that land, and not any of them own the land now. That old man built that house with the labor of his back, crude, and now it is dismal. It has imploded. And all the land, I said to my Ishaw, a consortium of men have bought all of that land. And that old man labored all his life for it. There's only one heritage, and that is the inheritance of truth for your sons and daughters. The land, the powers that be are going to take it back, all right? Don't worry about that. I brought nothing into this world. It is of certain. I'm taking nothing. You feed your children truth. Give them the love of Yah. They having food and raiment. Teach them to be contented. Teach them to be happy. I'm happy, man. I can eat. When I leave from here, I'm going to eat. You understand? I'm going to close from here, but it says in the book of Ezra, chapter 16, verse 71, it says, they shall be like mad or shaka men. They shall not, when Yah send the havoc upon this nation, they shall not spare none, but still spoiling and destroying those that fear Yah. You tell me those that fear Yah, he said they're going to spoil them. They shall spare none, but still spoiling and destroying those that fear Almighty Yah. Why? Because there's a day of trouble. It is the day of Yah's visitation that he has commanded. He gives us great insight in Hosea chapter 9, verse 7. For the day of the visitations are come, and the day of recompense are come. Yah says, and Israel, his nation, shall know it. How shall you know it? He said, because the nobby, the prophet, is a fool. The prophets are fool, and the spiritual men are madmen. The spiritual men, they're killing the people. They're madmen. For the multitude of your iniquity, that's why he's sending you those kinds of men. Because of your iniquity, because of the multitude of your iniquity, and your great hatred for Yah. We will say we love him, we're liars. That's what the Nobim Hosea says. For our great hatred. Our great Natsema, our hatred for Yah is Torah. Yah is doing this. Verse 72. For they shall waste and take away their things, and they shall cast them out of their house to understand that all of their riches. They're going to say it's not of any value. They're going to throw it out because it has no substance. It has no value. Those that are telling you to buy gold, you see what Ezra says? And the witness of that can be found in Yeskel, Ezekiel 7, verse 19. He said, they shall cast, same word that was used in Ezra 16, 72, and they shall cast the silver in the streets. And their gold shall be removed. Their silver and their gold shall not be able to deliver them. You're not going to have your shach in that day, and the day of the wrath of Yah. Why don't we tell the people that Yah has wrath? He has Ebra. Yes. Why don't we tell them? He said, your goal, you're going to go into your houses like Ezra said. He's telling a nation that have come out of captivity. He's trying to teach them the ways of Torah. He said, it's in that akarith. Everything in your house is not going to mean anything. You're going to throw it all out. Your gold, your silver, you're going to cast it in the street. Your children, get out. Because it will have no value, no substance, no reward. And it's not going to be rewarding. He said, they shall not satisfy their nephesh, neither shall they fill their bowels, because it is a stumbling block of their iniquity. That's your stumbling block. That's what prevents you. Your own iniquity, your own unwillingness to obey Torah, your own defiance of Torah. And that's why your goal is not going to save you. Your money, your fine suits, your sacked Fifth Avenue frock, honey. Your fake false horsehair weaved in your head. Your fake down plots in your head. Come on, talk to me. Yeah. Cannot go around Torah of Yah. It's not going to save you. It's not going to deliver you. Your hair down the head, it ain't not going to do nothing for you. You can weave. That's a silly thing. You got plots and weave horsetail hair in your hand. Some woman that sold her hair for food for babies in India and parts of the world. You silly women. You all are silly. Get that mess out of your head. Grow your own hair. Just grow. That'll be beautiful. You're silly. You're silly. I don't care what you say. You think you're beautiful? Oh, stop that heifer. You call my woman heifer? Well, y'all calls us a heifer, doesn't he? And we're backsliding heifer. All right then. Y'all calls us a heifer. How are you doing, my heifer? All right, excellent. Hallelujah. It is your own iniquity. This is what I want to get here. Ezra chapter 16, verse 73. This is your comfort, Israel. If I get nothing pointed out to you today, I want this to be pointed out. In all of the midst of all of that, Yah says of all of that holocaust of the Shoah, Ezra 16:73, then shall they be known. See, they're not known now. I don't care what these liars tell you. You can identify the tribe of Reuben, Simeon, Levi, and tell you Yahud is here in America and all Levi is in Haiti. It's a lie. Yah says here in the book of Ezra, chapter 16, verse 23, then shall they be known. Then shall they be known. What? Who are my bocher? It shall be known who are my chosen, my elect, my special ones, the ones of my bosom. Look now, how they're going to be known. And they shall be tried as gold in the fire. That's when it's going to be known who the elect. That's who's going to be known when it's the elect. That's who's going to be known, the bocher, the elect, the special ones of Almighty Yah. That's when it's going to be known. The Torah gives us a preciseness of that revelation as Yahshua speaks to us in Matithiah. Matthew chapter 12, verse 18. Hallelujah. Yeah. Yah says this. Behold, he called him his Evet, my servant, whom I have chosen. Has he chosen Yahshua HaMashiach? Has he not chosen us as his servant? He said, behold, my servant whom I have chosen. He said, my beloved. And whom, Yah says, my nephesh, my life, is well pleased. He said, I will put my ruach upon him, and he shall show judgment to the Gentiles. What does that imply? We've been taught by the religious world that that means all the Gentiles are coming in and all that. He said he's going to show judgment to the Gentiles because we as a nation, Israel, his people, we have become immersed. We look like Gentiles. We act like Gentiles. You can't tell a real Hebrew, Israelite, from a damn heathen of the world. Yeah.
Hallelujah.
And that's who he's talking about, Israel. Yeah. We will see the pattern in the Torah. He did not say one Philistine. He did not say one Egyptian. It would be in the balance sheet. He's going to save his house. He elected a house. He chose him above all nations that were the least of the nations. That's a fact. He's going to be judgment upon the Gentile. He's going to judge them for what they've done to the nation of Israel. Our papis, our forefathers, have been brutalized, abused. Then it shall be known in that time who are the children of Yisrael. And he tells us in verse 74 of Ezra, hear you, my beloved. He called us beloved, and we are stepping. Says Yah, behold, the day comes. He said, the days of trouble are at hand. And he says this, but I will deliver you from the same.
This is what he tells us.
Listen, be not afraid, neither doubt.
Stop doubting, Yah. Stop doubting what he's doing, even though things may look terrible to us.
He said, don't doubt.
Why?
For Almighty Yahweh is your guide.
He's your darak. He's the one that leads you. He guides you. It is a promise that even Yahushua HaMashiach, even as the Shelish Ach Shaul, reinforced that for us. Even as Yahkahan speaks, when Yahushua speaks to us in Yahkahan 16:13, he says, how be it when the Ruach of truth is come, the word come bo, when he has entered in, he will guide you into all truth. Not some of the truth, but all truth. And that's what Ezra said. He says, for Yah shall darak, he shall guide you. And when the Ruach of Yah comes, not the Holy Ghost. The Holy Ghost has led us into baptism, Methodism, Pentecostalism, Judaism, Lineism, but it had not led us into all called the fullness of the power of truth. He shall lead and guide you into all truth. For he shall not speak of himself, but whatsoever he shall shemach, the hearing of obedience, the ruach. Yah is ruach. He is not just a ruach. He is ruach. Ruach is life. He is the life of all things. He is the life of the dead. He is ruach. He said, but whosoever and whatsoever he shall hear, that will he. That shall he asa. He shall speak. He shall utter from the belly of Almighty Yah, and he will show you things to come. And you have the Ruach, and it's not showing us the preparation of man. What is the preparation? Well, the preparation of the heart in man, it is from Almighty Yah. Well, how does he prepare? He cuts out the filth and the wickedness by the sharp sword of the Torah and shows us how deplorable, how despicable we are. And if it's not for the mercies of God through the dam of Yahushua HaMashiach, he changes that we all would be in hell. You haven't done anything that is deserving of the kingdom. This is what it's going to take for us to enter in. You can look for the pancake syrupy stuff. You can be satisfied. That's why this Ahud said, she's going to just abandon it all. Do it, my Ahud, if you're listening. Shut your ears from them all. At a time the Torah of Yah doesn't indict you, then something is wrong. At a time the Torah is heard, it doesn't indict you. You know you raised hell with your wife. You treated her like a damn piece of a stick. You've overpowered your husband and treated him like a dog. You talk back to your mama, your daddy, you show, and you're not convinced and convinced of your sins. The Torah, the word of Yah, is the discerner of the thoughts and the intent of one's heart. And that's what he does every time we gather. Show us our own heart that we may repent. You can sit in your little groups there and do your little thing. It means nothing. We must learn how to shema. Hallelujah. Let me close here. He will guide you in all things, into all truth, what he shall hear. Ezra 16:76. This is what he shall do now. There's a reason why the Ruach, why Yah shall guide us. It says in Ezra 16:76, and the guide of them, the Ruach Yah is the God of them who keep, who shema, who guard, who heads about, who keep my mitzvah, my precepts, says Yah Almighty. Those are those that he got. How is he guiding one that keeps Sunday and Monday and one that doesn't obey the precepts of Yah? The Shikut. Hallelujah. He said, let not your sins weigh you down. Whose sins? No, your sins. Don't let your sins weigh you down, and let not your iniquity lift up yourself or yourself. Don't let your self-righteousness, your perverse manner, to lift you up to make you think you're something and you're better than me, I'm better than you. Don't let that happen to you, Yisrael. He said he's going to guide those that, again, here in Ezra 16:76, and the God of them who keep the mitzvah of Yah. We must keep the commands of Yah. We must remember the Shabbat. You don't buy and sell on the Shabbat. You damn Walmart. You don't go to Walmart, Dollar Mart.
Zachin was teaching last night. Someone wrote and said, Zachin, Yaramiya, what can I do on the Shabbat? Can I download messages and all that? And I responded. I saw the email. I responded. He will respond the same way I responded. I said, just rest. You can download the messages later. If you have to wait till the Shabbat, just rest. This is a Shabbaton. All right? Don't go to Walmart, Kmart. Rest your mind from all of this folly. Sit back. You don't go out and eat. Why would you go out and eat anywhere in a hog house? They cook and bacon and fat back and all that. Frying catfish. And you say, well, I don't eat that, but I want a steak. You silly man. Well, baby, we need to go sit down. We go out. We're going out of the living room into the kitchen. Put death on your man like that. Well, she, baby, I'm going to give you a break. No, a break from what? She's not doing anything. Okay, I'll break the pans open. I can cook now. You all know that now. I bust the pots and I bust them down for you. How can you go to a place like that? You wonder why we're in the shape we're in. You go into these greasy spoon places and eating their fat back. And you, well, I'm just going to get a piece of hell. They got every kind of swine meat it is up there. Every kind of piece of meat, they got swine and bacon and all that. Oh, I just want a beef pizza, baby. Well, hell, you take the same hand that put beef and put pork on there. We're silly as they come. Oh, I'm going to Bojangles, but I don't want no more pork in it. Well, hell, they frying pork chops and all in the same grease. They frying your chicken wings. No, just fry me some chicken wings, baby. I want some. I'll go to Von's Cafe and get some chicken wings. How about that? I eat them that way. I like chicken wings. Fried fish, fried chicken. No. We'll close here. All right. So those that he will guard are those that keep his mitzvah. This is our comfort here. This is our assurance in Revelation chapter 12 and 17. It says, and the Tanim, or this Nahash, the spirit of our mind, was angry with the woman, and went to make war with the remnant, the Bochir, the seed of her Zerah. Who is the enemy going to make war with? Only this one, which keep the commandments, the mitzvah of Yah, and have the testimony of Yahshua HaMashiach. Yes. Those are the ones. Those are the ones that Yah are going to guide, Yisrael. Yes. They keep the commandments of Yah. They keep the mitzvah of Yah. You can't say you keep the mitzvah of Yah. Here it is, love. Not that you say you love Yah, but he loves you. If any man says he loves Yah and keeps not his commandments, he's a liar, and he knows not, he walks not in the truth. So how can you say you love Yah and you will break the Shabbat, you will go to Walmart, damn Dollar Mart, and buy and eat and stop at the food house? It's wrong. I was thinking this morning, you know, I was thinking about Zachin Yeramiah. I said, boy, that talk, well, I said, but Yah said to Moshe, kill him, kill that bastard. He was out picking up sticks this morning. Kill him, kill him, kill him. Ouch. Killed him. You know what I thought about that? Because I didn't wake up last night. My fire didn't go out, but it went out. When I woke up, there was embering coals in there. I said, Yah, help me now. I'm not going to light no match. I got enough coals. One thing to do is just throw some stuff in there. But I sure went outside and got me some pine. Oh, you hypocrites, stop it. I got me a few pieces of that pine. 2x4s, I'm building my sukkot. And I threw it in there, and I got the blowing. And she, ouch. I said, you know, in motion, I said, even if you won't pick up, kill him. Kill him. Why? To rid this evil among Yisrael. And they killed him too. And they killed him. No, I should have had that. Ooh. Shouldn't have been out there picking up no sticks. But I didn't want my heifer to fall in a ditch. And if she fell in a ditch, I'd have to pull out. That's right, you see. It's going to take more labor to pull my heifer out of the ditch. Hallelujah. We are the ones, a sure word again here in Revelation 14 and 12. Here is the patient of the Israelite, Kedushim. Here are they, Revelation 14 12. Here are they that keep the mitzvah of Yah. And we have the faith of Yahshua. Those are the only ones that are going to overcome. You can talk your Jesus talk until you die. Yah's will, I will teach this in the years to come sometime. I want to teach this again. Is that all right? because I want to go through each verse. I want to show you the dynamics of that and the construct of his mind, whereby it is pervasive throughout Torah. Every scripture, I can show you the writing of that in Torah. I just didn't have time this morning. I awakened at 4:45, but I was lazy as they come. I said, I'm getting up at 5 so I can take time and research Torah. Well, I was lazy. I didn't get up until 5:45. So, took me a few minutes to.
Well, you're not supposed to start a found Shabbat.
These are lights, right? That's the fire in there, isn't it? Huh? So, there's no fire, is it? So when I do that, it's fine. So when you go in there and go, okay, that's fine. How about that? Okay. People are silly.
I want to ask you a question. Do you grow different seeds together?
Well, can I ask you a question? Can I reciprocate that with a question? Do you, you know, people like that, I say, yeah, I grow broccoli together with cabbages, and I grow collards, and I grow turnip greens, and we grow this.
Can I show you something in the Torah?
No, I don't want you to show me, because I know you're stupid. You talk to people like, sure, I know you're stupid. So you say to them, my friend, can you differentiate any seed in the Brassicas family, whereby you have Brussels sprouts, and Brussels sprout seed looks just like a collard green seed. Collard green seed looks just like a broccoli seed. Broccoli seed looks just like a cauliflower seed. Cauliflower seed looks just like a turnip seed. Turnip seed looks just like a kale seed. Kale seed looks like a lettuce seed. I said, you silly man. I don't want you to show me nothing because you don't know nothing. Well, let a fool show me something. Then you say to them, what do you buy your food, my friend?
Well, I'm just talking. I don't know what the Torah says.
You don't know nothing. Because if you knew what the Torah said, you would judge yourself, and then you would probably fast, and you wouldn't look the way you look. You probably fast more than you fast more, and you, because you wouldn't be buying all that you say you're buying. And you certainly would stop going to Fat Bubba's house and getting his collard green special. I'm not taking anything back. I ain't bowed down to this wicked world. I'd die. I mean that. Y'all, kill me in the battle. I don't mind dying.
Yes.
Kill me in the battle. Hallelujah. We greet you all. We pray that, first of all, Yah convicted you and showed you your sins. Send an offering. It's amazing that people will listen over the years and will not send one damn penny. Won't even send a nickel to help. They think it's just free. You know, they don't realize that the T1 lines we have here, they don't think it takes money to do that. This is how stupid this world is. And there are people that are bona fide. There are people that are listening for the house to be nourished and to be strengthened. And when they were in the whole house, they would give every nickel. We're not beggars. And we will not beg you for a penny. We don't have no schematics and scheme to take. You have taken, don't be an extortioner. You've been fed today. Send an offering. And I say that unapologetically. It costs for the equipment. We need upgrades and all that. It costs money. We can't go to Amazon.com and say, give us that camera. That's going to cost you $2,600. And all the other components, you got to add another 1,000. Hallelujah. Enjoy. It makes me no different who listens. Can I close with this before Zachin, our leader, comes to close out? And you know this love because I tell you the truth. If I was a hypocrite, I wouldn't tell you the truth like this. I'm not here for money. I'm going to die, and everything I have nothing. I don't own nothing in this life. I possess no land. I possess no riches. I possess no house. I have nothing here. I don't want nothing to hold me back. I'm going to teach this because I want to show us something. I'm going to teach this again, okay? After I finish this teaching on Hanukkah, okay? I want to show you something. I must teach it. I'm going to teach it from verse 1 to verse 76, all right? May the riches of your rest upon you all in Yeshua's mighty name. Come on, my Zachin Yaramiya. We greet you all again, our friends. May Yah strengthen you all in Yeshua's mighty name. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. We do brought Yahweh for his tender mercies, for his Ahava, for the Torah, his word he has given us on this day, this beautiful Shabbat, Yisrael Yah. Let us be a remembrance of those that are suffering, those that are weak and feeble in their bodies. Let's continually pray for Yisrael Yah. Because they're though they're truly going through trials, Yisrael Yah. We're not going through anything here, Yisrael Yah. We want to get in our own closets and clam up in our own little shells and thinking that we're going through something when there are those that are truly suffering. Hallelujah. So let us be in prayer for them, that Yahweh will strengthen them, provide what is needed on this beautiful day, that Yahweh, that his name would be lifted up. Hallelujah. And just something for us just to keep in mind, Yisrael Yah, even in this time of the year, as I had said on the broadcast last night, you see the trees blooming. You see the leaves coming out on the branches. And Yah, he has his way of doing things continuously. It's a process over and over again. It's a continual circulation. So we should allow his Torah to circulate even in our own hearts, Yisrael Yah. It's not to come into the body of Almighty Yahweh. We hear his Torah, we go out, and then that's it. No, it should continually be in our hearts and our minds. We should live it. We should obey it. And do it at all times, Yisrael Yah. Not allowing our flesh to overcome and allowing our flesh to have predominance in our lives, but allow the Ruach to have predominance. To have his word be the strength. And the thing that gives us light, Yisrael Yah, and give us understanding. So let us be ever mindful of his Torah. Meditate on that both day and night. And that we should do, Yisrael Yah. It should be in our hearts where he has written us that we could continue to press on. As the old Kedushah would say, that we may see what the end is going to be. Hallelujah. Let us stand to our feet, Yisrael Yah. And let us shoot, let us turn to Yerushalayim. We know that Yah, he has sent Yahshua HaMashiach to make us free. Not just to set us free, but to make us whole and to make us clean before the presence of Almighty Yahweh. Almighty Yahweh, we told you for this beautiful day you have given us, your Ruach, that you have poured out in the midst of Yisrael Yah. We do ask Almighty Yahweh that you would keep us, that you would continually show us, Abba Yahweh, our fallacies, our faults, Abba Yahweh, that we may get those things right, Abba Yahweh, and that your Torah will continually purge and cleanse us from all of our sin as you send your fire, Abba Yahweh, unto the house of Yisrael Yah. We do ask you will continually be with those that have come from near and far, Abba Yahweh. You will take them home safely, and that your melekim will continually be encamped around Yisrael Yah. And all things we do give you Todah. And we do barak you, Abba Yahweh, in the only name you have given unto man, which by we can be saved, Abba Yahweh. And all things we do give you Todah. In the precious and mighty name of Yahshua, our Yahshua, we do pray. Hallelujah. 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 Yah barak ko Yisrael Yah. Hallelujah.